Today we will discuss the important expected questions for the Aiims examination. Now what we would be focusing on today are the major questions that are related to science and technological developments. The first important aspect that we would understand is metallic hydrogen. It is for the first time ever that hydrogen has been discovered in its metallic form. So far, we talk about it in the gaseous form or a liquid form. And this metallic hydrogen can act as superconductor and can also revolutionize the idea of rocketry. The second important development that was discovery of a habitable zone, and that was named as Super Earth, LHS 1140b. So the name itself is important. It's a kind of habitable zone that has been discovered, which is nearly 40 light years away from the Earth, and it's an exoplanet that has been discovered. Now the next important thing was the human embryo that was formed by gene editing technique, which is known as CRISP. The acronym for CRISP is important. It is clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. And this CRISP technique is used as a system for gene editing. And this time you had the Cas9 genome editing technology that was used. This basically found out a successful deletion from a human embryo. The next is DeepMind. This is an artificial intelligence subsidiary of Google under the name of DeepMind. The idea is to navigate the complex environmental conditions by artificial intelligence. This company is a kind of British company that was founded in 2010. The next important discovery are the two organs that have been discovered. The organ 79 was discovered in 2017 under the name of mesentery. It is basically connecting the abdomen with the intestine, and this is considered to be a part of digestive system. The organ that has been discovered recently is known as interstitium. Interstitium is important because it's the 80th organ. So far, skin was considered as the biggest organ that has been discovered. But this interstitium is considered to be much bigger than skin, and it's basically the fluid that forms the gap between the skin and the various internal organs and the lining of the various internal organs. So this has been recently discovered in 2018 and is very, very important. The next is Sir William Hawkins, Stephen Hawking's. Stephen Hawking's recently demised, and his contribution to the science is very important. He laid down the idea of Hawking's radiation. He worked mainly on the singularity theorems and the framework of general relativity. His idea of theory of cosmology has been explained through quantum mechanics. He suffered from a syndrome which was known as ALS, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. That's very, very important. So the disease that Stephen Hawking had is again very, very important. We'll be talking about ALS in detail in a while. Some of the major books that he wrote are given here. Again, his books and his contribution to science is very, very important. So the universe in a nutshell, the shoulders of giant, God created the integers are some of his major works that he did. Now coming on to ALS, the disease that Stephen Hawking suffered from, it is a neurodegenerative disorder, and it's a kind of very rare condition. Usually after diagnosis, a person is expected to live only 2 to 3 years, but Stephen Hawking was a miraculous example or an exception who lived for more than 5 decades with ALS. Only 5% of the patients have a life of 20 years or more after diagnosis. Some of the interesting personalities who suffered from ALS were the playwright, writer, the Sam Shepard. Then you had the baseball legend who was known as Lou Gehrig's, and after his name you had this disease which was also known as Lou Gehrig's disease. So those are some of the famous personalities who suffered from ALS. The next very important step is monkey cloning. Now Zhua Zhua and Hua Hua are the two monkeys who have been cloned for the first time in Chinese Academy of Sciences. The word Zhong Zhong and Hua Hua basically means the people of China and the nation of China, and this was after the 79th attempt that a successful monkey cloning was done. Previously also you had the monkey cloning was that was done, but it was for the first time that it was done by using the somatic cell technology, where the DNA, the original DNA of the person is removed and the clone DNA is put into the recipient. So that's the technique that was being used. Dolly, which was the sheep, has been cloned on the same technique. Previously there was cloning of a monkey that was known as tetra, but that was not considered as a complex procedure, or that was not considered as a correct example of monkey cloning that time, because it was not through the somatic cell technique. Now some of the existing and the proposed All India Institute of Medical Sciences are given. Two of the recents have been proposed, one in Gujarat and other in Jharkhand. In Jharkhand it will be near Devgar. In Gujarat the site has not been decided yet. The other existing ones are given in yellow, and those in green are the proposed Aiims institutions. Now this is important because there can be a direct question on where the new Aiims are coming up. The next is about Professor Yashpal. His contribution to science is known basically for the popularization of science. So Kalinga Award is one of the very famous award that he has been bestowed with, and that is mainly for the popularization of science among common people. He was the chairman of University Grants Commission from 86 to 91. He was also the vice chancellor of Jawaharlal Nehru University. Then he was awarded the Bahadur Shah National Award, and he formed a very important committee for education, and that committee was known as Committee to Advise on Renovation and Rejuvenation of Higher Education. That's very, very important. He was also bestowed with Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan awards, which are the third and the second highest civilian honors. The next is Elon Musk's SpaceX. So SpaceX is one of the technology companies that talks about reusable rocket launch vehicles. And Elon Musk is the founder or the tech entrepreneur from South Africa for that company. This company was founded in 2003, and since then it has been working for reusable space rockets. Falcon 9 was one of the major missions, and now it's also supplying to NASA. It's working on a contract with NASA for supplying the cargo to International Space Stations. So Falcon 9 is of the family of two stage 2 orbit medium lift heavy launch vehicles, which have been manufactured by SpaceX. So you have the partially reusable option and the partially and the expendable variant that have been included in Falcon 9. That's again important. Inspire, it's very, very important. Inspire is basically innovation in science pursuit for inspired research. Now this is for the 2 lakh children from the age group of 10 to 15 years, basically the 6th to 10th standard children, who would be identified for the Inspire Award. Among the Inspire Award itself, you have SEEDS, that is a scheme for early attraction of talent, and that's for the young learners between the age group of 10 to 15 years. Then you have Luminol. Luminol is an important compound that is used for crime detection, and now it is considered that Luminol could be used for combating malaria or killing the parasites of malaria. That's the Plasmodium. The next is silvery fish. This is the world's first warm-blooded fish that has been discovered. It is of a size of a large automobile tire, and it's known in most of the oceans across the world. Webb telescope, it's again very, very important. It is one of the international projects that is led by NASA, ESA, that's the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency. The European Space Agency would provide Ariane 5 in collaboration with NASA. Now this telescope would be the world's premier infrared space observatory and the biggest astronomical space science telescope that has been ever built, similar on to the lines of Hubble telescope released by NASA. CURO is again very, very important. The acronym is Cryogenic Underground Observatory for Rare Events. Now this would detect the neutrino-less double beta decay from the natural decay of 988 crystals of tellurium dioxide, and this would be conducted in the country of Italy, and the institute would be Italian National Institute for Nuclear Physics. So those are the key points that you must know under CRUNO. Then you have biofortified maize. Now maize is the third most important crop in India after wheat and rice. Maize is known for basically, this version of the maize would be biofortified and it would be aiming to curb the hunger of a common man. Some of the three genes that it would contain are beta carotene, hydroxylase, then you have lycopene, cyclase and opaque 2. So those are the genes that it would have, and it would have also very high amounts of vitamin A and amino acids. The next is LIGO and gravitational waves. So gravitational waves would basically bring in a new aspect towards the theory of origin of universe. You have the following LIGO observatories that are already operational. You have two LIGO observatories that are under construction, that's the Virgo and the Kagra, and one in India that's planned. Now here you have an idea of how the gravitational wave spectrum works. So that's again very, very important. So LIGO and gravitational waves form a very important aspect. Now besides this, these were the important questions from the science section. Besides the science section, we'll be covering some other important questions that would form a basis for your expected questions for your Aiims examination. These would include the Chenani Nashari tunnel, or which is also known as the Patni Top tunnel. This is the longest tunnel that would be built in India, and it's the longest road tunnel connecting in the state of Jammu and Kashmir on National Highway 44. Then you have Dholia Sadia Bridge or Bhupen Hazarika Setu, which is built on Lohit River. It's the longest bridge in India. It's the first permanent connection that has been laid between northern Assam and the region of Arunachal Pradesh. So those two are the recent developments in the field of infrastructure. Then you have numerous fields, numerous developments in schemes and projects that we have already covered in the classes on expected questions. So you can go back onto the exam race current affairs and you can check out the important expected questions there on schemes and projects. So numerous schemes have been discussed there. Besides that, digital payment is very, very important, Digital India. So last time in 2017, there was a question on Bheem app. So Bheem app is basically a means of digital payment, and that was a kind of very direct question. Another direct question for 2017 was, what is the full form for GST, which is goods and service tax? So those are kind of very simple and direct questions that were asked. So be prepared for questions like those as well. Then sometimes there are general questions based on general awareness, like what is the color of a black box? So the color of a black box in an aeroplane is not black but orange. Then you have the first digital state of India, which is Kerala. Very important question, the orders of NEET that were given by the Supreme Court judge, and the judge there was A.K. Dave. Now since this order talks about orders for NEET, it's important the judge and who was the judge for those orders. So that's again important. Now what should you focus on is again very, very important. So you should focus on all the scientific and medical inventions that have taken place over the time. You should mainly work around the concepts that are related to basic history and polity of India. You should work around with ISRO and NASA developments. Also focus on the developments in the field of medicine, any facts and figures or information related to Aiims, new establishment of Aiims, expansion of Aiims, any new discovery done at Aiims. Then sports awards and honors are some of the other aspects that you must focus on. Now some of the past questions that were asked, we are just having a brief look on those. In 2014, there was a question, who is the longest serving Prime Minister of India? So Jawaharlal Nehru was the longest serving Prime Minister of India. Then in 2015, there was again a very general question from current affairs or general studies, that was, who gave the slogan Jai Jawan Jai Kisan? So this slogan was given by Lal Bahadur Shastri. Then 2017, we already talked about the goods and service tax and the Bheem app. Now besides that, you have two important sections that we recommend you should focus on. Those are the sections on science and technology and space and ISRO. So we have covered those in the link here. So make sure you don't forget to watch those. We'll be coming up with more classes for biology in general, and you would have chemistry and physics for your upcoming examination. So stay tuned. If you have any doubts, post those as comment below the video. Have a very good day ahead.